Hello everyone and welcome to Night Graphics. We have started discussing about stroke options in the last video where we discussed some basic options related to stroke like stroke weight, gaps, corners and alignment of the stroke. We will now discuss further. The next option here is to make the dashed line over the stroke. Here we have a straight line to experiment with. I'll select it and then in the stroke options here, I select the dashed line option. Now it is asking the length of the dash. Here I enter 20 points and then in this box, a gap between the dashes is defined. If I don't enter any value here, Illustrator will set the gap value equal to the dash value, that is 20 points only. But here I enter 10 points and you can see the results live. You can also set a pattern of dashes and gaps by further setting the respective values here. Like if I set the first dash to be of 20 points, first gap being 15 points, then second dash of 10 points and its gap being 10 points, and third dash of 5 points with its gap being 5 points. The result will be like this, having the same pattern of dashes and gaps according to the values we set. Alright? Then up here we have two options for the alignment of dashes. Let's experiment this thing on this square box here. I have made its stroke dashed by 20 points only. And right now this option is selected which says that it would preserve exact dash and gap length, due to which we can see that the dashes are not looking nice over the corners and it seems misaligned. The other option here says that it would align dashes to corners and path ends, adjusting lengths to fit. And if I select this option, it will align and adjust the dashes and gaps according to length of the path. And there it goes, and notice that it has done the job pretty well in the corners. This option works best even in the complex design. Like here we have a Batman sign here. And if I choose the dash line with first option, it is not looking good over the corners. However, this option will adjust the misalignment quite well. Alright. Now moving ahead with this line again, I'm unticking the dashed option for it now. Further, we have the option of applying arrowheads. This box sets an arrowhead at the start of the path and this will set an arrowhead at the end. Like here I set the start point to be this and the end point to be this and this is the result. Then this option will swap the start and end arrowheads like this. Then this field decides the size of start arrowhead. You can scale it up or down, and likewise this field is for scaling the end arrowhead. Then this is constraint button. If you press it and then increase or decrease the size of any arrowhead, the other arrowhead will scale proportionately. Then here if you see this line and its arrowheads, they are started and ended within the range of anchor points of the line. This is so because the alignment of arrowheads is set to this option, which places arrow tips at the end of the path. The other option will place the arrowhead beyond the starting and ending anchor points like this. Then at last we have the option of profile. Profile means the style of the stroke, which you can choose from the list here. Let's experiment it on this shape here. Currently the profile is set to uniform. This style is indicating that the start and end of the path will be narrow and in between it will go wide. If I select this, the style will be applied to this path. If you notice, it is narrow at the ends and wide in the middle. Likewise, we have some other styles which will work accordingly. Here in the stroke options box, we have two buttons associated with the profile styles. First is flip along, which will flip the style of the stroke. Like here, if I select this style, which is wide at the beginning and goes thin at the end, like this, and then press this button, it will flip the style and will make the beginning thin and ending wide. Then this second button is for flip across, which works when we choose the style where the stroke is aligned to right or left. This style is aligned to center uniformly and that is why this option is dimmed. Let's choose this style, which indicates that the stroke will be aligned to upper or the right side. This style is applied here and notice now this option is available, which will flip across the alignment of the stroke. Now I have pressed this button and notice that it has flipped the alignment of the stroke from right to left. Right? So this was all about the stroke options. Before ending up this video, I want you to notice one thing, that for aligning the stroke, we have three direct options here, which we discussed in the previous video about stroke introduction. These options will change the alignment of the strokes of a closed path only, like I am doing for this square here. But if I choose this straight line that is an open path, these options will go dim. And if I want to align stroke for an open path, I have to take help of styles given here, like we did for this open path. But then we have these limited styles only to choose from. So to overcome this limitation, Illustrator has provided a specific tool, that is this width tool, by which you can manipulate the strokes in any way you like. And you can also save your own stroke profiles. And we will learn about this tool in the next video. Thanks for watching NagGraphics, and don't forget to subscribe for the upcoming tutorials.